In this video, we're gonna go over some key concepts in order to keep you focused and motivated and really on the ball when it comes to becoming a dope rapper. So by the end of this video, what you're gonna know is what to look out for if you feel yourself waning or feel yourself hesitating at all as far as motivation, but also what should you focus on? Because we all understand and we all know that one of the main problems of being an artist in the 21st century, in 2016 or whatever time you're watching this, is knowing what order should I be doing this in? Should I be marketing right now? Should I be starting my own label? Should I do a fashion line? Should I do an Instagram promotional campaign? What order should I be doing it in? And then sometimes when you get into those tough situations where you're asking yourself these questions, you find yourself doing all of these things all at once and nothing ever really gets done. Sort of like the old expression, what is it? Jack of all trades, master of none. So I wanted to do this video to help you get a better idea of how to focus, what to focus on as an artist, as a rapper. And all of this information is coming from direct real life experience. This isn't theory. This is coming from over 2 years of coaching rappers from around the world, me personally, as well as being an artist myself for over a decade. So I feel like I know a little something about that. So if you sit tight, we're gonna go over this, all the stuff you're seeing to the side, but just as a general overview of what we're gonna be doing. We're gonna be talking about when you get these brilliant ideas, these great ideas, oh, you know, this is the reason I haven't blown up. It's this one thing or this one plan, and how that sort of manifests itself, and whether that's a good thing, is it a bad thing that I suddenly wanna start a label or I suddenly wanna do a podcast, all of that. We're gonna talk a little bit about what happens when you lose focus and you become less, give less attention to parts of your career. Maybe you should, and maybe you're just all over the place. We'll talk a little bit about what's the most important things to focus on and how do you make that decision. And we'll give a nice little example of a rap artist you probably know. And if you don't, I don't know why you're watching. How to learn how to rap. If you don't know who Kanye West is, maybe you should go read Genius or something like that. But without further ado, let's get into this. All right, so the first concept we're gonna be discussing here is the idea of that one brilliant idea. And you know that one brilliant idea. You know, you've decided you wanna be a rapper. Maybe you've been rapping for a long time. You can spit, or maybe you learn how to spit, whatever it is, you're becoming an artist, right? And then all of a sudden, might be 2 months into your journey, might be 2 years, might be 3 minutes into your journey, all of a sudden you get this brilliant idea. Why don't, instead of just being a rapper, besides just being the nigga that spits, the motherfucker that goes in on the mic, I'm a fucking start a label. Or instead of being a fucking artist and really developing your craft, I'm all of a sudden just start to make beats because I know Kanye did it or J. Cole does it. So even though I've only been rapping for 3 months, I'm gonna fucking start making beats and go on that journey. Or you get this brilliant idea to start a studio. You know, oh, I've been rapping for a little while, like I'm pretty decent, but you know what I really need to do is start a whole new business in the middle of my rap career and start a studio. Or, you know, all of a sudden, you know, me and my boys, we be talking shit. You know I'm supposed to be rapping in the booth and getting my pen game better, but I wanna start a podcast. Or maybe it's a clothing line. But these are all examples, and the reason I wrote them out is just because these are the common ones that you see. And you probably, if you're like any of us, you probably had one of these ideas before. You want to start a label, you want to do a podcast, whatever it is. I've been through it, we all go through it, and we get this brilliant idea. The reason I don't have any Grammys yet is because I haven't started the label. Or the reason I only got 400 followers is because I need to start a whole new business. So this is the first concept. You know, you are probably, if you're having trouble focusing or motivating, you might be going through one of these moments where it's like, oh, well, I was trying to learn how to rap, but what it really is I want to be a goddamn producer and turn into Pharrell, you know, or whatever it is. There's one brilliant idea. Now, is this a good thing or is this a bad thing? I'm gonna say for you right now, if you're a rapper, unless you're really, really happy with your skills, it's usually a bad thing. And the reason why is step number two, or idea number two. That is split focus. You're splitting your attention so that what happens is you end up not doing very well at either thing. So you come, you watch my videos, you wanna be a rapper, or maybe you're already rapping, you like watching my videos, whatever it is. And now you wanna start a label. But now, instead of going 100% all in to be a label exec and turning to Russell Simmons, you're also trying to still be that rapper guy and still trying to like develop your rap skills or whatever it is. And now what's happening is you're doing 50%, you're driving at 60 miles per hour in two directions rather than 100 miles per hour down the highway in one direction. So that's suffering from split focus, and this is not a good place to be in. And we'll talk a little bit. I already know what you're doing. You're already being like, but J. Cole can make beats and raps. Kanye does it. So, I mean, blah, blah, blah. Like, we'll get to that. But for right now, I just really want to hammer this down for you as we go through this journey here. First idea is you're probably going to come along the way as you're losing focus, trying to stay focused to some brilliant hatched up plan. Step two is you're going to start to have split focus, and you're not going to do either one well. So if you find yourself one of these ideas, and you can read in the video, look at any of these. Have you been there? I'm sure you have. We all have. You're going to get into that split focus place, and that's somewhere you don't want to be. All right. So how do you avoid getting into split focus where you're doing 50% on both, but you're still happy and all that? All right. You really need to understand the difference between in your career, a necessity and a luxury. What I mean by that is if anything on this list or anything in this brilliant idea, whatever it is, start a label, start a studio, whatever it is, if it is a necessity in order for you to be a success in the way that you want to be as an artist, then it might be something useful you might want to learn. So let me give you an example. All right, let's say that you have a little bit of money, you have a little bit of change, and you're an artist, and you're already dope on the mic, but what's really holding you back is your sound quality. But you're tired of going to the same studio, or maybe your town, your city only has one good studio and they're really flaky and they never show up when they say they're gonna show up, and it's difficult to get shit done. In that case, in order to be the artist you wanna be, it might be smart to start a studio because that's a necessity in order for you to be the great artist you wanna be. You're already dope on the mic, you already know what you're doing, but the sound quality is what's holding you back. So then, in this brilliant idea place, you put that in necessity. On the other hand, if you're just a beginning up and coming rapper, and a lot of folks who watch me are in the beginner to intermediate phase, and they're still learning how to like ride the beat properly, how to switch flows, how to get a better voice tone, all the stuff we talk about. If you're in that category, like starting a label is not a necessity. That's a luxury. That's just some other shit to split your focus. You start a label maybe when you already have a massive fan base, and now you need to have other people handling your booking, handling your marketing, so you can be on tour and do what you need to do. Hire a tour manager, get a label together, etc. A lot of your favorite rappers that you look up to, you think, whether it's like a Hopsin or somebody like that, or Logic with Visionary, or J. Cole with Dreamville, you're probably thinking, oh, but they started a label and they're a rapper. It's like, dog, don't put the cart before the horse. First, what they did is they got to such a massive level of success and notoriety that having a label behooved them. SAT word, behoove. It really helped them to fuck out, basically, all right? So what I want you to do is anytime you get one of these brilliant ideas or you find yourself in split focus, come to center and be like, all right, what's a necessity versus a luxury? So how to rap, for example, like if you notice, I'm practicing what I preach. What have I been doing for 2 years? Just teaching rap and like being a rapper, of course, so I can like tell you real shit, but I haven't, there's no like how to rap record label yet. There's no how to rap studio. There's no, I did a little podcast and we might do that later on. If y'all want to see a podcast, put it in the comment box. I don't know. But you know, we don't really do any of that. I'm still focused on this one big thing. Now, I have started an online coaching class because that's the way I can work directly with artists to help them get better, be a better coach, etc. So I put that in necessity. Can't be a coach if you ain't coaching nobody. So that's a necessity. But like how to rap label at this point right now, right here, that would be in the luxury category. So that's just me using an example of something I would do. Now, let's just, as we've gone through these 3 points, and I don't want to keep you all fucking day, you know what I'm saying? So let's just think of the example. Remember I told you your brain's already clicking off with, well, Pharrell does 80 things, or, you know, there's rapper like Donald Glover, you know, somebody like that who does a lot of things. All right, but probably the biggest and most notable example of this is Kanye West, right? So I wanna, using this framework we just talked about, talk a little bit about how Kanye did it, how you could possibly think about it, and how this all still works together. All right, Kanye West, when he was first starting, and you can watch his old interviews, and you probably know his basic life history. I mean, he says it in every fucking song, and plus he's like uber famous, and I ain't talking about Uber like the new taxi. I'm talking about he's really famous. You know his life story. He started as a beat maker. Now, I don't know Kanye personally. I never met the guy. I'm a fan of his music. It'd be great to meet him. It'd be very interesting. But I can guarantee that there was a good 4 to 5 years, if not longer, where beats was Kanye's main focus. Again, he says it in his music. 5 beats a day for 3 summers. You know, all that. That's a different world, 3 summers. He starts with beats. So you see, I have this little like down. So in that time, he was focused on one major thing. He wasn't in that split focus range. I'm sure he was rapping, and part of his goal was to become like this big rap star. So yes, that's a little bit of like in that necessity, still trying to learn, but he was focused on one thing. Once he got to the premier level of being that, then he can move on. Then he moves on to becoming the rap artist. And he does that for about 4 to 5 years. Like, he was always a fashionable guy. He was always into fashion. We know that. But between, let's say, college dropout to roughly 808s, maybe, he was just a rap artist. That's what he was doing. I mean, he was making beats. But even then, if you notice, he started to rap on other people's beats as quickly as Late Registration, for example, that has other producers, I think. If Late Registration or Graduation. I know Graduation has Late Registration didn't Just Blaze do Touch the Sky. Fact check me on that in the comment box. But the point is, pretty quickly on, he was focused more on rapping, and in that period, that's what Kanye was doing. You know, he starts to use other producers. Needles produced Barry Bonds with Wayne, etc. Now we can see Kanye's moving into the fashion world. You notice in his interviews, he's talking more about fashion. He's got the shoes coming in. So he moved into another category. So that's the way, if you really want to be like one, do all of it and be the Kanye West, Donald Glover, that's fine down the road. But you need to stay focused for a long time on one thing, one primary thing, separating into necessities and luxuries, and then you can move on. So hopefully this video helps. A lot of key concepts, trying to give you a lot of good information, but let's just review to make it clear again one more time. All right, how to stay focused and rap. You know, when you have a big, brilliant idea out of nowhere, when you're still focusing on blowing up and becoming a rapper, it's probably a bad sign, because what's gonna happen is you're gonna get into split focus, and then you're gonna be moving, you know, you're gonna be putting on the accelerator or also putting on the brake on both, rather than just going 100, 0 to 100 real quick on one major thing. And what you want to do is stop, think about, okay, what is actually a necessity for me in order to be the artist I need to be? If I need to learn how to promote myself on Instagram better so I have more notoriety for my music, then that's a necessity. And yes, you can have a brilliant idea how to market yourself. But if you're just doing it because you think it's cool to start a fucking podcast or clothing line, it's a luxury, and you don't need to do that shit most of the time. We went through an example of Kanye West, many other examples. If you look at all of the rappers and all those people, if you really look at the life stories of the Donald Glovers, the Will Smiths, the Nick Cannons, the Pharrells, the multi-talented people, they usually have one major focus for 4 to 5 years, and then they move on. Yes, they still do the other stuff and they're still good at it, but you gotta put all your eggs in a row. You gotta focus one at a time. So hopefully this helps. Hopefully you understand that this is real life examples. I'm sure you relate. Be sure to let us know in the comment box, all of that. But no matter what, I really want you to understand, you need to be able to focus on one major thing for a long time to become an expert at it. So you're not in that split focus region, excuse me, and you're not all over the place and basically being whack at all of them or being mediocre at all of them. So hopefully this helps. I'm your big homie, Drew Marcy. If this is your first time watching us and you enjoyed it, be sure to subscribe, tell your friends to subscribe, like, share, comment, all of that. If you've been watching us for a while and you haven't followed us on all social media, be sure to do that. It's How to Rap Drew on all social media. And of course, be sure to sign up for our free newsletter, free daily newsletter, where you get tips not available on our YouTube or anywhere else, directly to your email inbox every day. You get a cool little video with it. It's awesome. But no matter what, hopefully this helps, and I'll talk to you soon. The big homie Drew. And I'm out.